I'm pleased now to announce an additional speaker, Jose Mendez, who is visiting the hub this week. Jose joins us from Portugal, where he's professor of physics and vice-rector for research at the University of Aveiro. Jose's research has focused in the last years on the study of properties of complex networks, and he's famous for his contributions in the field of small world networks and recently introduced a new index that measures the relative importance of researchers. Please welcome Jose Mendez.
Okay, thank you for the introduction. As you saw in the background of my name, there was no network, so because I was around this week here in the Institute, and so Stefan gave me offered me the possibility to say something or contribute a bit for this conference. So I will try to give you my simple view about this. So I put in a timeline the Big Bang, so the beginning of everything, and the collapse of our solar system, and somewhere in the middle, of course, we are here. And before us, there was a huge amount of, in the last, say, 2,000 years of bright minds that contribute a lot for the understanding of the past, but also for the understanding of the future, including the fact that we know that we will disappear one day and things like that. But the challenge is to understand this small region there, and that's why we are here. So however we seem to understand in a macroscopic scale what's going on, we apparently have problems in understanding this little bit in time. I think Andreas cites Einstein and said something like that, so we can have information, knowledge, but this is not enough. So we need our minds to create things and things like that. So this is, of course, very, very important. It should be present. So I will do a kind of SWOT analysis, okay? So I will try to, in short, because I didn't have time to think too much about this, but I will try to put in each of these boxes some ideas and then continue. So strengths, I put here network science, and by network science, I mean mathematical tools, physical laws, everything I put there. So I put also deep learning, so people already talk about this, and the fact that we understood nowadays that science is broad, so we cannot think as specific disciplines, etc., etc. So I put here, these are some strengths, let's say. Then I put opportunities. So opportunities means that you can all the time make new questions. There are challenge things like many diseases we don't know, the brain, target medicine. So there are lots of things that we still need answers, and so they are challenges or opportunities for us. But then there are weakness, and I put here a need of fundamental understanding of many systems. So we should understand from the microscopic point of view many things, for instance, like brain. Many people make analysis about brain, they do fMRI, etc. But so they see, like, kind of, we are seeing the forest, but we are not seeing the trees and things like that. So we should go deep and understand from the microscopic point of view many systems, and this we don't know. And of course, the need of a multi-scale approach. And then there is threats. And by threats, people already mentioned some of here. I should add a line here that is OK against complexity. So I should put this line here also in mind, but I didn't know that. So funding policies, taxpayers' understanding. So how they, Roberto also mentioned that. So the pressure to fast results, we all know that these things. The strategies of journals that sometimes drive science in some directions, et cetera, et cetera. So, for my understanding, this is somehow killing the freedom of thinking, so the creativity. So I put this together, so I put this in a formula. I put this in a formula, so there's a function where everything enters. And so this is a kind of a cost function. We should change this formal, the parameters of this formal, in order to have a better life, a better society, a more sustainable world, etc. So these are the goals. But so it means that we have to play with this formal. As I said, there are in this formal positive contributions, there are negative contributions. So we have to, the point is to optimize, in fact, optimize this function. And I think this is the whole of complexity, the whole of people working on this area. So, but what we have? We have data and information. So for instance, I mentioned here in short sensors, think about cars or these watches that people now every use, they measure all cardiac, etc., all information about the body. But cars, for instance, a modern car have hundreds or thousands of sensors. And the car, I would say, I don't know, but maybe it works 1 hour per day, a car, in average. Most of the time, car is stopped on the street. So if you use all these sensors that are in the car to measure the weather, the temperature locally, it means that you have the temperature in every 2 meters or something like that in the world. So you see, you can have lots of information, as you can imagine. The brain, social networks, so there are lots of information around. And so my suggestion is, so you have this data information, we have deep learning, we have network science. In fact, I think that each one can learn. I think deep learning can even improve using network science. And this will contribute for a better understanding and better predictions, like Miguel suggests and things like that. So in some sense, here I have the engineering part, and there I have the science part of Miguel. And so basically is what I share his opinion. Basically, we need, and this is also the responsibility of scientists. So we need a kind of Fosbury effect. I don't know if you know that, but until 68 or something, people in high jump use this technique. And in the Olympic Games, a guy appeared, Fosbury appeared with this new technique. And this was a crucial change because it's proved, let's say, that you cannot jump more than 2 meters and 34 with this technique. And nowadays people go almost 2.5 meters or something like that. So you see, we need also something like that, so creativity and change a bit in our field. Thank you very much.